solve it in a tedious way and then find a way to simplify it. So this is a related problem. So this time, we still look at n digits for general restraint. But then we are more interested in counting the number of strings with even number of zeros and even number of ones. So I will call it Bn, this number. And then to help us find Bn, let us also define two more types, Cn and Bn. Cn is the number of strings with even zeros or ones. And Bn is the number of strings with odd zeros and even ones. Is that okay? So we can use Bn, Cn, Bn to get the number of strings with odd zero or one. It is equal to 4 to the power n minus, it should be BCD, minus Bn, minus Cn, and minus Bn. Is that okay? Okay, let us establish the recurrence. Okay. So let's have a recurrence from here. So how do I get a string with even number of zeros, even ones? So length n. So let us consider a different scenario of what happens here. Okay. So maybe this part it has even number of zero, even ones. So it is even. Even 0, even 1. Then, if I add a 2 or add a 3 in the end, this will be a string with even 0, even 1. Is that okay? And similarly, if we have even 0, odd 1, then I can add a 1 here to make it even, even. Is that okay? And then if I have odd here, even here, then I can add a 0 to make it okay. Is that okay? So Bn will be equal to, using our notation, Bn will be equal to 2 times Bn minus 1 plus Cn minus 1 plus Bn minus 1. Is that okay? So this is the recurrence for this one. And we have what? We have Cn, right? So Cn is even off. So how can I even off? So I get with Bn minus 1, I get even, even, and then add a 1, so I get even more. Or what? I can have a Cn minus 1, which is even odd at the beginning, and then I add a 2 or I add a 3, so I will get even 1, so I have 3 times of Cn minus 1. Is that okay? Or odd even, I cannot get even odd by adding one single bit. It's impossible. But there is one more case. If I start with odd, then I can get even odd by adding a zero in the end. So I will be able to get something. So this is what we have for Cn. Okay, this we can simplify a little bit, so it's actually equal to Cn minus 1 minus Cn minus 1 plus 4 power. Okay. And then similarly, we will have Bn. Bn is, I want to have odd even. So I will start with even even, and then add a 0. So or I can have odd even, so I want to get odd even, so I will start with Bn minus 1 and then add a 2 or add a 3. So I have 2 times of this one. But I cannot get odd even from even odd. That's too much. Still, I can get it from odd odd. So I will have 4n minus 1 minus Bn minus 1 minus Cn minus 1. Bn minus 1 minus Cn minus 1 plus 4 to the power minus 1. Is that okay? Okay, so let's do some checking. So we know what? We know that B1 is equal to 1. So if it is of length 1, then there are two possible cases to have even 0, even 1. Is that okay? And then we then I would have to C1. C1 is equal to 1, and the P1 is not equal to 1. So, to make things nice, more nice looking, okay? So I want to set up what is B0, B1, and B0, C0, and B0.
Okay.
So, I want to have what? I want to have B1 is equal to 2 times B0 plus C0 plus B0. And I want to have C1 is equal to C0 minus B0 plus B1. And then I want to have B1 is equal to C0 and the other thing. So I want to get this. Did I? Let me see. Yeah. Is that so far so good, right? So whatever you like, you can set C0 to be 1, D0 to be 1, and then B0 to be 0. You can set something like this. So that everything will be okay. You can also set, okay, strangely, so this is from the textbook, that you can also set B0 to be 3 over 4, B0 to be 1 over 4, and B0 to be 1 over 4. Okay? Whatever you like. So let's say what I like most is, let's try C0 is equal to B0 is equal to 0. So we can set C0 is equal to B0 to be 0. And then we will set B0 to be equal to 1. Is it good? Yeah. It also makes sense. Yeah. There's one string with even number of zeros, even number of ones, but the length is equal to 0. Okay. Yeah. You can set something like this. And then what do we do next? We will list out a bunch of formulas for B, a bunch of formulas for C, and a bunch of formulas for D. So we will get something like, so for B, we will have what? We will have B1 is equal to 2B0 plus C0 plus B0. Is it okay? And then we will have B2 is equal to 2B1 plus and so on and so forth. And then we have Bn is equal to 2bn minus 1 plus cn minus 1 plus bn minus 1. Is that okay? No. And if we sum them up, so what are these sums? We have an x squared, x to the power n here. We have an x squared, x to the power n, x squared. X to the power n, x squared, x to the power n. Is that okay? Then what do we have? The left hand side will be equal to the general radio function of bx minus b0. Is that okay? And then this will be equal to, how about this one? Oh, this is nice. This is equal to 2x bx. Is that okay? Plus x times cx. X times D of X. Is that okay? Did that make any sense? So far so good, right? Then we also have the case for C. So the case for C will be equal to C1 is equal to C0 minus B0 plus 4 to the power of minus 1. Okay. And then we have C2, C1, minus B1, plus 4 to the power 2 minus 1. And then Cn is equal to Cn minus 1, minus Bn minus 1, plus 4 to the power 2 minus 1. And then we have 4. you sum everything up, this one, you will have Cx minus C0. So C0 turns out to be 0. Okay? So it's equal to this one. This one is equal to x times Cx minus x times d of x plus. So you have this one multiplied with x. This one x squared. This one x to the power n. So we have done this before. Going to be equal to x divided by 1 minus 4. Is that okay? And then if we do this again, then we will have dx. Dx turns out to be symmetric. Dx will be equal to x times dx minus x times cx plus x over 1 minus 4. Is that okay? Good. Just imagine you have big dx, big cx, and big dx are the variables that you want to solve. Just this time, each one is not a value, each one is a function. Okay? You have three functions, three unknowns, so you can solve it. Is that okay? So you can substitute ax into one formula, or substitute, sorry, there's no ax, substitute cx or dx into one formula, and then you can solve it. That's the idea. Okay. So, but for this problem, we can actually solve it much easier. So let us read a look of what is going on. So, the number of strings with even zero and number of strings with odd ones. It must be equal to the number of strings with all zero and the number of strings and even ones. The reason is that you just swap this zero and one. Zero becomes one, one becomes zero. You get another string. There is one to one correspondence. So you don't need the end. You have this one as the end. So the end is actually equal to C n. Then what do we have? Dn minus 1 will be equal to Dn minus 1. So suddenly, it's 1. Actually, I know what is Dn. Actually, I know what is Dn. Is that okay? And so the remaining is this point. Actually, I know what is Dn, I know what is Dn. So this is now fixed. So Cx and dx, they are all the same. So this one will be equal to, actually we know what is Cx and what is dx. Am I correct? So this will be equal to what? This will be equal to, so Cx turns out to be equal to 1 over 4 times 1 over 1 minus 4. It is just a function for B only, and then you can can solve it quite easily. Okay. Is that okay? So this is the most difficult example of the first set of slides. And let us try to use this generating function technique to solve another problem. Another type of recurrence.
Or the eternal node may look like this.
or the internal node may look like this. Is that okay? So in that case, A3 is equal to 5. Is that okay? Well, n is equal to 4 would be very complicated. So, 40. So, what is the relationship? So how do you get AN? So I call it AN, right? How is AN related to? So how does it relate to? So we are finding recurrence. So how is it related to A1, A2, up to AN minus 1? If you want to make a term for A0, how should A0 look like? So we will talk about it later. So this is the problem. So if we can get the recurrence, then we can start solving it. Okay. So what is AN? So AN is a tree that has n internal nodes, right? So one of the internal nodes must be the root. So it has to have a root. And then what can go on this side? And what can go on this side? Maybe this has zero internal node on this side, and then this has n minus one internal node on this side. Right? Or maybe there is one internal node on this side, and then n minus two internal node on this side. Is that okay? Or, and so on and so forth, up to what? Maybe this can have n minus one internal node on this side, that has zero internal node on this side. So how many trees of this type? Zero internal node on this side and then n minus one internal node on this side. How many cases are there? This will be a n minus one, am I correct? So this is for this one. This will be a n minus one cases. How about this? How many cases? Will be A1 times A minus 2. Is that okay? And then the next one, if there is the next one, then A2 times A n minus 3. Is that okay? Up to AN. So the AN will be again AN minus 1, right? Right? Now, so to make things regular, so I have to make things regular. So let us introduce a term called A0. So in this case, I don't want to call it AN minus 1. I hope to call it A0 times AN minus 1. And similarly for this, the last one, I don't want to call it AN minus 1. I want to call it AN minus 1 times A0. So to make everything looks like a convolution. So in that case, what should be A0? So this would be 1. Because I hope this one to be AN minus 1. So let's create A0 to be 1 parallels. Is that okay? Now what do we have now? Okay. This will be very interesting. So I have A1 is equal to A0 times A0. What we have. A1 is equal to 1, and then A0 times A0 is 1 times 1, 1. Good. How about A2? A2 turns out to be A0 times A1 plus A1 times A0. Am I correct? A3 will be more complicated, so we will have a term A0, A2 plus A1, A1 plus. Yes, plus A2, A0. Is that okay? So in general, AN will be equal to summation of, this time K is equal to 0 up to, so So you add up, that is up to n minus 1. A k, a n minus 1 minus k. Is that okay? Okay. And then what do we do next? We multiply x2, a1. This is x. We multiply x squared. Multiply x cubed here. Multiply xn here. Okay. And we sum them up. Now, this is the tricky part. Sum them up. A0 times x squared, and so on and so forth. This looks really like ax times ax. It is ax times x. Very good. So this is equal to x times this ax squared. Is it okay? Does that make sense? Okay? Now, amazing. This is what? What is amazing? So far so good, right? Good. So what is A? So what is A? So I can rewrite this as what? I can rewrite this as x times ax squared minus ax plus 1. Am I correct? Is that okay? I want to solve ax. This is the unknown. X something times an unknown square minus the unknown plus 1. I want to solve for the unknown. Ah, sorry, that's okay. This is equal to 0. Yeah. So I put everything on one side, 0, 0. So this is actually a quadratic equation in the unknown ax. So quadratic equation, we know how to solve. A is equal to minus b, so this is plus 1, plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac. Divided by 2a. Is that okay? You just, so previously it is in terms of x, here it is in terms of ax. So you think of all the things that is not ax constant. Okay? Ax is the unknown that we want to solve. And suddenly, we use quadratic equation to solve the root of quadratic equation to solve this one. This is ax. But notice that you can't have two generating functions for ax because only one of them would be correct. Which one is correct? You need to be careful, okay? So either plus will be correct or minus will be correct, right? But we know what? We know a0 is equal to 1. A0 is equal to 1. One of them should be rejected, right? Let's see. So far we have this one. Is that okay? So let's find out which one is going to be rejected later. Okay. And then how do we solve? How do we solve for? So we now have a generating function for ax. How do we get an? Well, easy. We know what it is, right? We know what it is. So an will be what? So an will be the coefficient. Let's try. Number of minus here must cancel with the number of minus here. So actually, I can write this as this one. I will be choosing plus or minus so that everything will now become positive. So I can have all this term plus up to the last term. What is the last term? So the last term is going to be 2n minus 1 divided by 2. Is that okay? So I will have n plus 1 terms overall. So I will have n terms here from 1, 3 up to the n. So the last term was like 2n minus 1. Is that okay? Multiply by 4 to the power of n plus 1. Then what should we do? You will use the standard technique. Okay. So we have n plus 1 terms in the top, n plus 1 terms of 4 here. So we take a 2 to cancel everything. So that this becomes 2. And this is 4. Is that okay? Is that okay? And okay, there's a 2 here. There's a 2 here, so let me cancel one more time. There's a 2 here. 4. Is that okay? And then I will multiply n factorial to the bottom and multiply n factorial to the top. So it's the balance. Is that okay? I have these 2 multiplied with each of these n terms. Then I will get what? I will get 2, 4, 6, up to 2n. So these 2, together with this n factorial, will help me to get all the even terms up to 2n. And then I have all the odd terms up to 2n. So all these things will now get us 2n factorial. Is that okay? Altogether, so far, we have this 2n factorial. If you are okay with this so far, could you please raise your hand? Okay? So we just need to simplify this. This is not that difficult. N plus 1 factorial is equal to n plus 1 times n factorial. Is that okay? So in the end, so this is going to be choose n, and then this number divided by n. Let's check. Okay, so when we have done things for a long time, yeah, we better check it. So check what? Let's check when n is equal to 1, whether it is working. 2 choose 1, 2 divided by 2, 1. Okay, and then 4 choose 2, which is 6, divided by 3, you get 2. Is that okay? So the next one is 6 choose 3. What is 6 choose 3? 6 choose 3 is 6 times 4 divided by 3 divided by 1, so it's 20. 20 divided by 4, you get 5. And the next one, if my memory is correct, it should be 14. Let's try. The next one is going to be what? 8 choose 4 divided by 5. Okay, 8 choose 4 divided by 5. Okay? So 8, you get 8, 7, 6, 5, and then you get 4, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2 cancels with 6. 8 and 4, you get a 2, so 2, 7, 5, so it's 70. 70 divided by 5, it turns out that it is equal to 14. Okay? So this number is interesting, right? So first of all, I just want to tell you that the technique here is the same, akin mechanical. The most difficult part here is you need to observe that when you get a convolution, it is usually the product of two functions. Here, the functions are the same, ax, ax. Sometimes you may get a different type of convolution, like ak and then b, blah, 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 minus 1, for whatever. And in that case, this will be ax times bx. Is that okay? So this is the first thing that we want to understand. The second thing is that for a generating function, with the relation like this, we can treat it as a normal quadratic equation or cubic equation or whatever, and solve for it, find the root of it. After that, everything will be easy. Okay.
Okay.
So, just a few more things to talk about. So this number is special. This number is called the Catalan number. This number is called the Catalan number. So this is studied by a mathematician called Catalan. It appears in a lot of places. So for instance, let's look at triangulation of a polygon. So I have a triangle. I want to make it into a triangle, so there is just one way, I do not think. Okay. If I have a quadrilateral, I can have two different types of triangulation. One is like this, and the other is like this. Is that okay? Two. For a pentagon, so I will be having five different triangulations. One is, so I draw five of them first, just to make sure that I don't miss anything. So one is like this, the other is like this, the other is like this, the other is like this, and the other is like this. So that's going to be five of them. Okay? And therefore, hexagon is going to be 14 of them. So perhaps, yeah, for this question, yeah, this is usually a question that appears in our assignment. Maybe Simon will ask you to prove that this has the same effect. And also, how about matching parentheses? So the number of ways to have expression with one pair of matching parentheses is like this. With two pairs, you can have this one. Or, is that okay? Three, you can have something like this. Let's continue one more example on Thursday. So we will finish the discussion on the purpose.